Gee, 140 million copies? Who would have thought of that? Congratulations, Rockstar. You nailed it out of the park for a really, really popular game that's popular no matter what the odds are. Let's get this video started and out of the way. Congratulations, Rockstar. Catch 'em all. So, yesterday, it has been official that Rockstar has now sold 140 million copies of Grand Theft Auto V, which is the game on the screen that you're seeing right now. It has been official that they have officially sold 140 million copies, making it the second best-selling, most-sold popular game in the entire world. And this game, actually, a couple of years ago, was actually the number one most popular entertainment product ever, even over other video games, over movies, over TV shows, over anything that you could really, really think of that is entertaining. This game ended up taking the number one spot, and lucky enough, Rockstar's latest game, Red Dead Redemption 2, also hit that list as being the second most popular entertained product of all time. And I'm telling you, Rockstar just keeps on nailing it out of the park. But there's a lot of fans out there that really want the next Grand Theft Auto game to be released or somewhat teased and whatnot, and I can get their frustration a lot right now, because now this game is getting ready to turn 8 years old by the time this coming up September hits, in which most likely that's going to be the release date of this game on the third generation of consoles in a row that it's been released for. Now, a lot of people are really, really mad at Rockstar right now because of the fact that they're re-releasing this game for a third console generation in a row, and I'm personally not, because I know that GTA 6 is going to literally be the biggest map that we are ever going to see and basically the biggest game ever. So, like, with the sales of GTA 5, if GTA 6 is going to be as big as all the rumors are speculating and that some of the insiders that work at Rockstar are saying, then Rockstar is just going to be having another tremendous game that is going to basically sell just like this one is. And they're not going to slow down on sales. They're not going to slow down whatsoever. Rockstar is just going to continue to keep selling as many copies as they possibly can. But when is the time that it's going to come out in is the thing we're wanting. But I can almost guarantee you that GTA 6 is still at least most likely at the minimum 2 years to like maybe somewhere around 4 years still away from right now. I see the game coming out maybe as early as late 2022, but most likely it won't come out in late 2022. Most likely, it's most likely going to come out in 2023 if it was to come out any early. But honestly, the game, like, people act like it's like, you know, like the game's going to sell no matter what. Grand Theft Auto is the number one most popular gaming franchise in video game history. Like, you can tell by the sales of this game, the sales of GTA 4, which still sold 26 million units, which that's still a really, really lot. And San Andreas has made it very, very close to GTA 4's number with 20 million units, and I'm telling you, everybody acts like this is so surprising when it's not. Grand Theft Auto is so skyrocketing. Now, it is really surprising that GTA 5 is continued to sell like nuts, but it's not all that surprising when you know that a game series like this that sells a lot, it's not really the most shocking thing ever. It's just, man, like, it just keeps selling. But we're also going to talk about the new gen version coming out later in the year. Now, the way that it's looking like is we're going to have to buy the game again. But if Rockstar ends up, which I bet they probably are, but who knows, they probably won't. But if Rockstar ends up announcing this game here in the next few months and announces a release date for the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X, and they say that the game is going to cost $60 again, or possibly even $70, since new games are going to start costing $70 on the new generation of consoles, it's just not going to go good for Rockstar anymore, and it just will not go good, and they're going to get like tons and tons of backlash. So I think it's stupid if they are going to resell the game again, which most likely they are. That's what they're known for. They are known for being a greedy company, and also, like Take-Two Interactive, they're also a greedy publisher. But if I was to say something, and we have to pay, you know, the price of the game again, like buy it again out loud, then I would personally think that this game should only sell for anywhere between 20 to maybe 40 bucks at the most. It will not be worth a full 60 bucks or even a 70, being like, oh yeah, it's only next gen, we gotta show it for $70. It's like, no, it's not worth the $70, and it is not worth the $60 again. If anything, I honestly think that maybe $30 that it currently sells for right now is probably a good price, but I honestly think that they should just give the game out for basically everybody that technically owns it, including me, which there's going to be millions upon millions of people that do own it. I mean, really, Rockstar, you're not losing money either way, even if you were to give this game out for free on the next-gen consoles for people that already own it. I mean, you are announcing at your earnings calls that you keep making the best money, you're making the most every time when it comes to shark cards, and you've made like quite a few billion dollars off the shark cards alone. Like, really, Rockstar? Like, you're making the money off the shark cards, and if you were basically like giving the next gen versions of this game for free to everybody when it comes out, you're not going to be losing money either way, Rockstar. So it just doesn't make any sense for you to recharge a 8-year-old game again for a third console generation. Now, don't get me wrong, I have spent so many hours on this game. This is like the best game in the world that I love, and I still play tons and tons of hours still to date. But I'm telling you, for the game being out for a total of 8 years coming up, it's just not worth the money, or even at least worth the $60 or even the $70 that next-gen games are starting to cost at. It's not worth the full $70 or even the full $60 again. Honestly, if anything, I honestly think that it should be staying at $30, because let's face it, if you really want to sell it again, then do not ask for a really, really big price for especially a 8-year-old game. That's going to really turn off a lot of people, and including myself, but I'll still get the game either way, so that way I can make YouTube videos and continue to enjoy it on the new systems because that's how bad I want it. But not everybody is the same, and I still would much rather it be given us to for free for basically owning it on last generation hardware. That's honestly what they should done, or what they should do, I mean, because let's face it, Ubisoft's doing it. Even though CD Projekt Red screwed up really bad, even before all that, they're basically giving their game Cyberpunk out for free when it does come for the next gen consoles, and they've even announced The Witcher 3 coming out for the new systems, and if you own it, you get free upgrades. So honestly, I mean, I could be wrong, Rockstar might do it, but as from what I understand, Rockstar is just not going to give this game out for free for you owning it when it comes out for the PS5 and the Xbox Series X. It's just not. But congratulations, Rockstar, for hitting 140 million copies of Grand Theft Auto 5. It has been an honor for this game. This is Infernal Shard 1 for the win signing out. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys could, please smack that like button if you enjoy this content, and subscribe for those of you that are new to the channel, and we will be sure to keep you guys posted with more gaming content in the future. And also, comment down below in the comment section down below of your thoughts of Rockstar hitting 140 million copies of GTA 5 and what you think that Rockstar should do when they re-release this game for the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X later this year. If you think that they should charge $30 only, or if you really think that they should give us a free upgrade, which personally, I'd much rather do the free upgrade, but if they want to charge it, I think it would be better if it's like a $30 game and not a full $60 or $70. So just send me down in the comment section down below of your thoughts, and also hit a like I said, if you enjoy the video, and subscribe for those of you that are new, turn on notifications so you don't miss out on any new gaming content in the future, and we will catch you guys on the next video. Peace out.